today is our last week in our 10-week series on grace. And you can enjoy really diving into that word, all that God's Word has to say about it. It's such a familiar word, we tend to overlook that word. Someone once told me, if trees produce wildflowers, we would plant trees everywhere. It's too bad they only produce oxygen. And then they said, oxygen is so vital for life, right? It's so vital for life. In the same way, we need oxygen for our physical body. We need both for our spiritual. There's a busyness of life and the casualness of sin.
Thank you. word may communicate at times the whole thing is confessing. You don't even think of it running a weakness, or as you come getting in trouble, or when you're in trouble, that things will come to you. But God wants us to confess so you can forgive. And confession is more about finding grace than it is making it. And through that story that we looked at, we found that grace finds its way in the way that we need to be forgiven. And today, we are going to talk about Zacchaeus. And so, what came to you, we're going to talk about the story of Zacchaeus, the wee little man, and the wee little man was who? You know that story. But you have a bulletin, and if you go and pull out your phone, I want you to follow along as you study and go through the story together. If you have your Bible, you can turn to Luke chapter 19, or just follow along on the screen, and talk to this will be the story on the screen as we reach through that today. So, Luke 19, this is 1 through 10. And here's what it says. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus, who was the chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but because he was poor, he could not see over the crowd. So he stood and prayed to climb the sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was standing that way. When Jesus reached the step and looked up, he said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay out of here today." So he came down and welcomed to him gladly. All the people saw this and began to know he was going to be the guest of the Son. So Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost."
Thank you.
Zacchaeus wasn't Jesus' first dealing with tax collectors. The disciples were also a tax collector, so Jesus had already kind of broken his ground and ended up dealing with these types of individuals. And he wasn't afraid to spend time with the least money in the society. So, here is what he was in he wasn't talking with Jesus, he learned a few things. And I think that's pretty much the case of all of us. When we encounter Jesus, when we experience his grace, we take an awful lesson, a bigger lesson to learn. Zacchaeus was no step of question. There are three lessons that Zacchaeus learned through grace. And here's the first one. Being poor in spirit is better than being rich in wealth. Being poor in spirit is better than being rich in wealth. Zacchaeus is rich. He is poor than he is poor than he is ministered male first. Best came a roaster you could buy with. Filthiest, dirtiest. He is rich. And Zacchaeus had four commandments and following dreams. I'm husband's back, and he's crying, and I could get my attention to that. You could have been contagious. Are you crying? Are you sitting at the right side to feel the sunshine? It's amazing. I'm scared. I'm sad.
I'm going to go to the next one.
I'm going to go ahead and Thank you.